Fella, can't you see? You're boring. A guy like you should wear a warning. It's dangerous. I'm falling. I just can't escape. I can't wait to get away. Far away from you. You're dangerous. I'm smelling. Getting late to give you up. Don't take a sip from the devil's cup. Slowly, I'm getting over me.
Episode of Preacher Man TV. I'm glad you guys could join us today. I know that you're going to be blessed. So let me introduce to you who's in the studio. We don't have much people today because I guess we have a Thanksgiving later today. So a lot of people couldn't make it. So we have yours truly, me, in the studio. And then we have the man, my riding dose, my son, my boy, Joshua Seth. I must apologize to him last week. I didn't shout out the poor man, you know, and he went home all broken. You know, and tried and tested because of it. But but I'm shouting them out today. So guys, we have some cool stuff for you today. So what I want to get to first is our Preacher Man topic of the day. There's a million videos floating out around cyberspace telling us how to get rid of toxic people. They tell you how to keep your personal space, well, personal, and how to limit your sphere of influence and all that other good stuff. Indeed, you really want to avoid toxic people. You know, the people who after you're done talking to them, you feel worse about yourself. You know, the kind that smiles with you, hugs you, and then stabs you in the back, but you don't realize it until you've almost bled to death. It's smart to avoid toxic people. I'm not going to add to the long list of videos that bash your toxic teammates, however. I want to make you think a little bit. Ready for this? Do you ever realize everyone knows toxic people, but no one ever stops to ask themselves if they themselves are toxic? I mean, it's easy to berate everyone else, but it's quite difficult to find a person who is willing to identify the toxicity in the mirror. I know people are hard on themselves and they beat themselves up, but they often do so over trivial things, like when they make silly mistakes or a wrong decision over an investment. You hardly ever see people chastising themselves over their propensity to gossip or their willingness to step on someone else's head to get ahead. So how do you know if you're toxic? Well, I'm glad you asked. If the most important person to you is you, then you can never be good for anyone else. You're toxic. I'm not saying people like that are never helpful. Sometimes they are, but only up to a point. They are willing to help other people as long as those other people remain beneath them. If you are your biggest fan, then toxicity is inevitable. If the only way you can make friends is by bad-mouthing someone else, then you're toxic. Friendships that are formed under dislike for someone else is toxic to its very core. If someone approaches you and their opening statement is something along the lines of, "I can't believe that idiot would treat you like that," run! Run, run. If you're willing to do anything, including trashing or hurting someone else to get ahead, you're toxic. People often disguise this horrid trait as business acuity and street smart. Nope, you're just a horrible person. If that's you, change. I know sometimes you have to be ruthless in order to get ahead, but humility is not stupidity, my friend. You can be resolved yet respectful. You don't have to be ugly. Ugly doesn't suit you. If everyone else has a problem and you're the only rational one, you're toxic. I've seen this too many times. Everyone hates me. Everyone is so mean. I can't make friends. But you never stop to consider that the problem might just be you. If you must change someone, start with yourself. If you must blame someone, look inside. If you often find yourself saying things like, "I don't need anyone. I'm a loner. People are just nasty," chances are you are toxic. Ask yourself, why do people choose to separate themselves from your company all the time? I know they will separate you from their company for the gospel's sake, but that's because the world will see the believer as toxic to their immorality. But if on a social and personal level, you are compelled to walk alone because you can't even get along with others at work or even at church, then your toxicity levels are high. Toxic people constantly take and never give. They ensure that their bad moods negatively affect everyone around them. They are often very disrespectful when their true emotions are on display, but very respectful when things are going their way. This means that they're deceitful. Don't try to identify people like these in your life. Ask yourself, am I one of them? Every good Christian spends time in introspection. This goes beyond mere navel gazing. We have to constantly align ourselves with the epitome of perfection, Jesus Christ. Everyone he met, he loved and even challenged them to become better, not only by words, but by his sheer presence. Everyone, Pastor Jay? What about the religious people? He spent most of his time trying to help them. They were constantly trying to figure out how to do what he did. They crucified him for envy because they wanted to be like him. If people must hate you, let them hate you for the right reason. Don't be toxic. Now think about that. Right. Guys, I hope you got something from that. Let me tell you something. There's a lot of toxic people out there. You know, I know we have to try to avoid them. And the Bible tells us, you know, there's some people you just have to separate yourself from. But at the end of the day, make sure you're not one of the people that we have to separate ourselves from. Why? Because as Christians, we must always be approachable, must always be willing to lay ourselves on the line for people. Okay, so let's get to the Preacher Man clip of the day. So there is a difference between the husbandman and the servant. There's a huge difference. The servant is one who has abandoned his own interests for that of his master. So when the servants come in, we are recognizing that these are people who do not have their own will, but they have the will of the one that they are serving. The husbandmen, they work for the master, but they are getting paid to do so. One man is saying, "I reject my own will for that of the will of God." One man is saying, "Unless he blesses me, I will not change my will."
So we have to ask ourselves, which is the majority in the church today? Those that are servants or those that are husbandmen? Men and women who just come into church waiting for God to give them a healing or a blessing, waiting for God to do this. And if God doesn't do it, we want to tuck tail, turn around and run. Every time the pastor says something slightly offensive, oh my God, well, there's so many churches out there, we could find a better one. The Bible says in the last day, men shall heap up unto themselves teachers having itching ears. These people will say things that they would love to hear. I tell you that they are all husbandmen. They're looking for God to bless them in order for them to praise God. But I believe that God is raising up a generation who will serve God, who will reject their own will and say to God, Lord, it's not my will, but thy will be done. Amen. That's what we have in the church. You know, if men learn to be less selfish, you know, if you just learn to reject your narcissistic traits, then guess what's going to happen? You're going to be happy. Have you ever realized that most of the time when you're unhappy is because somebody did something to you? Yeah, but if somebody comes and they do something to you, but you don't have that love for yourself. All right. Let me clear it up. I know Whitney Houston said learning to love yourself is the greatest love of all. She should just say, narcissism. Yeah, because learning to love yourself is the worst love of all. If you don't believe me, let me tell you what Jesus said. Jesus said, if any man should come after me, let him first deny himself. Yeah, then take up his cross and follow me. There's a generation who will be servants of God and not just husbandmen. We're not here for the food. We're not here for the blessing. We're here because we know that our God is a good God. We're here because we know that his blood was shed so that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Oh God, could I preach to you a little bit? Could I preach to you a little bit? I don't care if God never gives me another blessing. I don't care if he never gives me another dollar. I don't care if he never gives me another healing. I don't care if there were no heaven, there were no hell, if there was no streets paved with gold, if there were no mansions to receive, and we had to wade knee deep in blood to get to the throne of God, I'd still do it. Why? Because the cross of Jesus Christ is too powerful to reject. Yeah, the cross of Jesus Christ is too wonderful to ignore. Yeah, why would we leave that? Yeah, like I said yesterday in the Thanksgiving, some people say, well, I believe in Jesus and I believe in the cross and the work of the cross, but you need to understand, I need to live my life before I can make that kind of commitment. You're not even a husbandman. Yeah. The truth is, before you make that commitment, trust me, have you ever seen a man drowning and you throw him a flotation device? And he says, before I make this commitment to this flotation device, let me think about it. Well, that's what we are. We are men drowning in desperate need of a savior. We don't have to think twice about it. As soon as he comes and he says, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. As soon as he comes to you and he says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. As soon as he sounds the clarion call and he says, behold, I stand at the door and I knock. As soon as he says it, it's time to leave everything behind and follow Jesus.
So, I hope you guys enjoyed that. Yeah, just wearing some... Right, so I hope you guys enjoyed that. You know, to get those Preacher Man clips of the day, it's not easy. So, I think that's kind of harder sometimes than actually doing the actual clip. So, I hope you are blessed. And I want to encourage you to like, share... And if you haven't subscribed yet, subscribe. We take a lot of time to put these videos together. This goes into the Preacher Man Insider group. And we also post it on YouTube, which anybody could see. But at the end of the day, we share it on Facebook. And when you share from YouTube to Facebook, Facebook kind of suppresses the video. So we don't get as much views as we normally get. But that doesn't worry us. Why? Because we're looking into building up the Preacher Man community. So invite people to come into the Preacher Man community, encourage people to subscribe and to share if they like what they see. I hope you guys enjoyed the rap from last week. I enjoyed that one. It was fun making that video. Yeah, those kind of things are easier to do than the skits and the short movies and whatever, you know. But that doesn't mean we're not gonna do that. You know, we're gonna have models coming up soon. So Until next time, guys, I love every single one of you. And don't forget to share this stuff. We love you. See you next time.